Hello learners, here we are back with the introductory module of Legal Aid Services. I am Kuntirani Pradhan, Faculty of Law, National Law University, Odisha. Now, as discussed in the introductory frame, that the first subunit of this module will deal with Legal Aid Services. Now, let us know what is Legal Aid, where did it initiate, and what was the initial zonation where Legal Aid was encountered by people and how people came to know about Legal Aid. Now, what is Legal Aid? Legal Aid is a provision of assistance to people who are unable to afford any legal representation for courts and they cannot go to the court system just because they are indigent. So, always Legal Aid is considered very pivotal. It's considered very central in providing access to justice. Now, how do you consider Legal Aid as a very important instrument of delivering justice? Because justice cannot be denied to any citizen of the country by reason of any economic or any other disability. Now, dating back to the history of France, where in early 1940s, they started with some schemes that dated back and that helped the indigent people to fight for their rights and also they were entitled to forms of legal aid through any sort of monetary relief or some other sort of monetary or non-monetary relief. So legal aid is essential for guaranteeing equal access to justice. And when we date back ourselves to 1953, we see that the Article 6.3 on Convention on Human Rights in Europe says about the legal aid and guaranteeing it to the community as a whole, no matter whether they are indigent or they are not. Now, when we look into the concept of legal aid in India, it started not in the pre-independence era, but it started post 1952. That means it started after the Constitution of India was adopted by the people of our country. So it started from 1952, where different law ministries, law commissions, they came up with different ideas of incorporating legal aid into practice. Now, who was the pioneer of the legal education or the pioneer of clinical legal education system in India? So, let me tell you that Justice P.N. Bhagwati, who was one of the noted jurists, he is considered to be the most important person. He is the pioneer of initiating clinical legal education as well as floating good legal aid schemes in our country. Now, when you look back to 1980s, the Committee on Implementation of Legal Aid Schemes, that was chairman there, it was done under the chairmanship of Justice P.N. Bhagwati. It started a surge of legal education and also it started to float legal aid schemes in our country. Now, what after 1980 was done was something very much instrumental in incorporating legal aid in our country. The institution or the establishment of Legal Services Authority Act in our country in the year 1987 was a major step through which the country had an idea of what is legal aid, how a person can get legal aid, who is entitled to legal aid. Now, because some act or the other, when it comes into force, it is always that we should understand the implications and how it has to be developed and how it has to be used by the citizens. So after much hue and cry, this act came into force in the year 1995 on 9th of November. So my dear learners, let me tell you that 9th November is celebrated as the National Legal Services Day. Most importantly, when we date back ourselves to the constitutional amendment, that is the 42nd Amendment of 1976, we see the inclusion of Article 39A, which speaks of equal justice and free legal aid. And much after that, when there was an enactment and then the use of this concept called legal aid after 1995, the people of our country were very much happy that at least if some person is not having any proper resources to move to the court, then they can take help of this specific act. Now, Section 2(1) Clause C speaks about what is a legal service. Now, in the context of the Legal Services Authority Act of 1987, Section 12 is the most prominent section which gives us the essential criteria of who is entitled to legal aid, where we find that a woman, a child, a person of any undeserved want, any industrial workman, any person who is a victim of trafficking, and another 8 to 10 sections which is dealt in the subsequent transcript and the relevant transcripts given in the self-learning materials will let you know about the section in detail. Now, when section 12 comes into force, we always get to know that there is an apex body which coordinates all the work of this specific nature. Now, let me tell you about the organizational structure of the Legal Services Committee. The NALSA, National Legal Services Authority, this is the apex body which deals with each and every legal aid work that is coordinated in whole of the country. Now, the NALSA is the apex body and the Chief Justice of India is the Patron-in-Chief of NALSA, whereas the Executive Chairperson or the Executive Member is the senior most judge of the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court Legal Services Authority, it works under the NALSA, under the directions of the NALSA. Other different organizational structures which come under the hierarchy of NALSA, they are some very important, they do some important work, which starts with the State Legal Services Authority. And then again, the hierarchy goes down to the District Legal Services Authority. The High Court Legal Services Committee or the High Court Legal Services Authority works directly under the State Legal Services Authority, whereas the Taluka Legal Services Committees, they work directly under the District Legal Services Authority. In the relevant self-learning material that is being sent to you and that you will be reading, it gives a very distinct organogram of this hierarchical structure, which will make you aware about what is the hierarchical structure, who is the executive chairman of these respective bodies who work to do legal aid and who helps the country and the indigent people to get their rights. Now, this is about what we will be discussing in this specific unit. This unit basically will give you an idea of how to approach the appropriate authorities, what are the specific issues that you can deal through this National Legal Service Authority, how can you approach the SLSAs, how can you approach the DLSAs, what are the functions of the TLSCs, and how can you as an individual also incorporate yourself in the decision-making process regarding any sort of legal aid that can be provided to any indigent person. So, I hope to see you in the next video lecture, which will directly give you a proper idea about what is a public interest litigation, which is another a very surging dimension of legal aid. So, thank you so much and see you in the next video lecture.